Hello student, we are Punya Study Circle and again extending you cordial welcome in our classroom. Today we are going to conclude our third part of accounting terminologies. That is going to be the last concept of accounting which we must learn before starting our general accepted accounting principle chapter and accounting standards. So let's make ourselves familiar with all these concepts so that we can start our next topic. Here we are having data, store, revenue, entity, turnover, livestock and investment as well as their types. As I have mentioned on the board, debtors. Debtor is those customers to whom we have sold goods on credit. For example, Sudha is our customer. She came to us and expressed her inability to make immediate payment for the goods that she desired to buy. We allowed her to buy the goods and to make payment on some later date, or we are giving her allowance for a period. She may have two options. Either she may give written consent that she will make payment after a particular period or on a specific date in the future, or she may simply ask us for credit purchase. Yes, if we allow her against acceptance, then she will not be called debtor, she will be called our bills receivable. That is legally enforceable. That means we can oblige her to make payment if she expressed her inability to. But in case she has not given any written acceptance, she will be just termed as our debtor. In future, she may behave in three types. So, debtors may be of three types. Either she is very much likely to make payment, then she will be called our good debtor. If we have high degree of trust, yes, Sudha will make us payment on the determined date or on the given period, within the given period to her, then she will be termed as good debtor. If she asks us some more time, in that case, we also develop a sense of doubt. She becomes doubtful debtors that might she pay or may not she pay. If she expresses her complete inability that I am not going to make payment because I have become insolvent, in that case she will be called bad debtors. So we are having three kind of debtors: good debtors, doubtful debtor in which we are having doubt, and those debtors which are proved insolvent are called bad debtors. The amount is irrecoverable from them. Here we are having next concept called store. These are those materials, those things which are held by a business entity for its personal use and not for resales. Like lubricants, we are having engine oils, grease, nut bolt, spare parts, tool, packing material. All these are helpful in maintenance of machine and hygiene at the workplace are called stores. Here we are having revenue. Revenue means total recurring nature received to a business entity over a particular period of time. Here you must ensure two things about in order to categorize any receipt as revenue receipt. The first thing is they must be related to day-to-day activities of business entity, and secondly they must be regular in their nature. So we are having two types of revenue. Total revenue is composed of two types of revenue: operating revenues and non-operating revenues. Operating revenue, as name implies, revenue or received from the selling of goods and services are called operating revenue. Or rendering of service, whatever kind of service we are rendering if we are a service entity. Second thing, the amount received from the investment, the amount received as a rent on the let out part of property, or amount received as a commission for the advice rendered to some client or the service rendered to some customer are called non-operating incomes. When we make these two incomes total, that is called total revenue. Operating plus non-operating revenues are called total revenue. Then we are having entity. Entity means economic unit that is engaged in production of goods and services or their sales for earning profit. That means entities may be of two types of, either they are industrial entity or they are trading entity, or there may be a combination of these. That means we are having backward and forward integration, that is called corporate houses or business entity as well. Here we are having turnover. Turnover in accounting means simply gross sales received to a business entity are called turnover. But turnover is a broader concept. In industry, we mean total amount of sales and purchases called turnover. But here you will denote it by gross sales made by a business entity during the accounting period is called turnover. Here we are going to study about livestock. Livestock means the quantum or number of domesticated animals or tamed animals for productive purpose being held by a business entity, like dairy are having stock of cattle, poultry farming are having stock of chicken, like pig farms are having stock of pigs, Boochery houses are having stock of some kind of medieval animals. So all these things which are alive and had for business purpose are called livestock. Here we are having last concept of it, that is called investment. You know what is investment? Investment means long-term deployment of fund in a business entity. It may come from owners in terms of capital, and it may also come from financing institutions like commercial bank and non-banking financial companies, even mutual funds that trust in us and provide us long-term fund which we can use for increasing return to our shareholders or our owners. That means total capital employed and investment are one and same. Capital employed means long-term investment in the business entity is called investment. I'm sure that you are much familiar with all the concept or all the terminologies of accounting. In our next lecture, we will enjoy our understanding development of general accepted accounting principles and accounting standard. Till then, have a good time. We continue on your study and stay safe, stay home. Again, this message is delivered to you. Bye-bye.